morning children. Today we will learn about the mensuration of the things or objects. What do we mean by mensuration? The measurement of area and volume of the objects or shapes is called mensuration. Okay? Usually from our surroundings we will have two types of objects or shapes. They are the plane shapes and solid shapes. Okay, the plane shapes are called 2D shapes and the solid shapes are called 3D shapes. Okay, 2D means two dimensional and 3D means three dimensional shapes. Okay, so children, first we will learn about the perimeter of this plane shapes and then we will learn about the area of this plane shapes. Okay, now I come to the perimeter of the square. Okay, here square is a quadrilateral in which all the four sides are equal, right? So I have taken the square ABCD which is having 3 centimeter sides. Okay, here all the four sides are equal, right? If I ask you to find the perimeter of this square, what should you do? The perimeter means the sum of all sides of this square is perimeter of the squares. Or in general, I can say one full round length of an object is called perimeter. Okay? So here, perimeter of square ABCD is the sum of all four sides, that is AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. Okay, here all the four sides are equal. So if length of one side AB is A units, then I can say AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. Therefore it is A plus A plus A plus A units. That is why perimeter is equal to 4 A units. Here A means length of one side of the square. Since one side of the square is 3 units, I write 4 into 3. That's why 4 threes are 12 centimeter. Therefore, one full round length of this square, one full round length of this square is equal to 12 centimeter. Or the sum of all four sides of this square is 12 centimeter. Okay? Now we see one more example. Here, PURE, pure. This is also a square. How many squares are there? Here, there is only one square of 5 centimeter. Okay? This is one square of 3 centimeter. This is one square of 5 centimeter. Okay? If I ask you to find the perimeter of this square, what do we mean? One full round length of this object or shape is called its perimeter. If we start from P, then PU plus UR plus RE plus EP makes one round. Thus, one full round length of this shape is its perimeter, or the sum of all four sides is its perimeter. Therefore, children, perimeter of the square PUR is equal to PU plus UR plus RE plus EP. Here, all the four sides are equal to same unit, 5 centimeter. Okay? In general, if PU is equal to A units, the other four sides are also A units. Therefore, A plus A plus A plus A, it is 4 A units. Thus, 4 A is equal to, A plus A plus A plus A is equal to 4 A units. So here, the length of one side of this square is 5 centimeter. Therefore, I put A is equal to 5 centimeter here. Thus, 4 5s are 20 centimeter. Thus, perimeter of this square pure is equal to 20 centimeter. It means one full round length of this square makes 20 centimeter. Okay. Now, let us take the perimeter of a rectangle. See here. ABCD is a rectangle, right? Here, DC is length of the rectangle, CB is breadth, BA is again length, and AD is breadth of the rectangle, okay?
If I ask you to find the perimeter of this rectangle, what we will do is length plus breadth plus length plus breadth makes one full round length of an object or rectangle. On the other hand, the sum of all four sides makes its perimeter. Therefore, perimeter of the rectangle ABCD is DC plus CB plus BA plus AD. Okay, I start from DC plus CB plus BA plus AD. It is nothing but length plus breadth plus length plus breadth. Therefore, I rearrange the terms length plus length. Okay, then breadth plus breadth. Okay, 2 times of length plus 2 times of breadth. If 2 is taken out, inside it is into bracket L plus B. Thus, P is equal to 2 into bracket L plus B is the formula to find the perimeter of the rectangle. Okay, but P is equal to 4A is the formula to find out the perimeter of the square. Okay, P is equal to 4A is the perimeter, the formula to find out the perimeter of the square. Whereas P is equal to 2 times of length plus B is the formula to find the perimeter of the rectangle. So children, here perimeter is equal to 2 times of L plus B. So it is perimeter is equal to 2, length is 6 and breadth is 3 cm. 6 plus 3 is 9, therefore 9 twos are 18 cm. Okay, thus perimeter of the rectangle ABCD is 18 cm, means one full round length of an object, means of this rectangle, is equal to 18 cm. That is the meaning of perimeter of the rectangle. Okay, what if a triangle's perimeter is asked? Okay, let us see the perimeter of triangle PQR. Okay, so here PQR is the triangle in which PQ is 6 cm, QR is 10 cm and RP is 14 cm. Okay, here all the three lengths of the triangle are different. Okay, the lengths of sides of all the three the lengths of the sides of the triangles is different here. So it is a scalene triangle. Okay, this is a triangle in which all the three sides lengths are different. That's why it is a scalene triangle. And I take its perimeter. Perimeter means its one full round length is called perimeter of this triangle. Okay, or the sum of all these three sides of the triangle is the perimeter of the triangle PQR. So here PQ plus QR plus RP makes the perimeter of the triangle. If I take the length of PQ as A units and QR as B units and PR as C units, then it is PQ is 6 cm, QR is 10 cm and PR is 14 cm. Thus children, the perimeter of the triangle PQR is equal to sum of all three sides. That is PQ plus QR plus RP and they are A plus B plus C. But A is 6 cm, B is 10 cm and C is 14 cm. Therefore, the perimeter of the triangle PQR is 30 cm. Okay, means one full round length of the triangle makes 30 cm. That is the meaning of perimeter. Now, look at the triangle ABC. Okay, here ABC is an equilateral triangle, means all the three sides of this triangle are equal. Here AB is equal to BC is equal to CA and all sides are equal to 10 cm each. Okay, therefore children, the perimeter of this triangle ABC means AB plus BC plus CA, that is A plus A plus A. Therefore it is 3A units. Okay, therefore the perimeter of the equilateral triangle is calculated by the formula P is equal to 3A. Right? Here A means length of one side of the equilateral triangle. That is 10 cm. Thus, 10 threes are 30 cm. Therefore, 30 cm is the perimeter of this equilateral triangle. Okay? Now children, let us take the perimeter of the circle. We know that perimeter means one full round length of the circle is called its perimeter. Okay, it means the boundary of the circle and the perimeter of the circle and the circumference of the circle, all are same. Okay, if we consider a point here, right, from this point to, if we take one full round length, then circumference is completed. Okay, the length of this circumference or the length of the boundary of this circle is called perimeter of the circle, or one full round length of an object is called perimeter of this circle. Okay, take thread and align the thread at this point. Okay, you just fix one end of the thread at this point and go on aligning the thread along the circumference of the circle. Okay, when the another end of the thread reaches here, then you stop. Then you can hold it to the measuring tape, okay, or meter scale, and the length of the thread gives the perimeter of this circle. Okay, on the other hand, to find the one full round length of this circle, what we call as perimeter of the circle or circumference of the circle, we have a formula called 2 phi r. Therefore, perimeter of the circle is calculated by the formula 2 phi r. Okay, that is 2 into, phi means 22 by 7, r is radius of the circle. Here radius of the circle is 7 centimeter. Therefore, I put r is equal to 7, right? 2 into 22 by 7 into 7. Here 7 and 7 will get cancelled. Thus 22 twos are 44. Therefore, 44 centimeter is called the perimeter of the circle or circumference of the circle. Is it clear? So children, the perimeter or boundary of the circle is called circumference of the circle. Okay, the perimeter or boundary of the circle is called circumference of the circle, and it is measured in units like centimeter, meter and kilometer. Okay, the formula to find the circumference of the circle is 2 phi r or phi d. Is it clear? Okay.
Okay children, in this session we learned how to find the perimeter of a square. The perimeter of a square is, okay, calculated by the formula 4 times of a, and the perimeter of a rectangle is calculated by the formula 2 into bracket l plus b, and if the triangle is equilateral, then the perimeter of the equilateral triangle is calculated by p is equal to 3a. And if the triangle is scalene, then the perimeter is calculated by the formula P is equal to A plus B plus C, where A, B, C are the lengths of the sides of the triangle. Okay. And similarly, the circle also has a perimeter. Okay. Perimeter means one full round length of an object is called its perimeter. Okay. The circle's perimeter means it is the perimeter of the it is the length of the circumference or length of the boundary of the circle. Okay, so the perimeter of the circle is equal to circumference of the circle, and that is calculated by the formula 2 phi r. Okay, where phi is a constant called, its value is 22 by 7. Okay, so children, in this session we have learnt about the perimeter of the different plane shapes. And in my next session, we will see the area of all these plane shapes. Okay? Till then, goodbye. See you tomorrow.